हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी डिस्कस अबाउट अमर्त्य सेन। ओके, आज का हमारे राइटर हैं अमर्त्य सेन और आज हम इनके बारे में बात करेंगे। इन्होंने लिखा है टैगोर एंड हिज इंडिया एसे। इन्होंने टैगोर एंड हिज इंडिया, इसमें टैगोर के बारे में और जो इन्होंने बंगाल में इंडिया में किस तरीके से वर्क किया, ये जो कुछ भी इनकी जो योगदान रहा है, कंट्रीब्यूशन रहा है, उन सब के बारे में बताया था। ओके, अब हम इनके बारे में पढ़ते हैं। नोबेल लॉरेट अमर्त्य सेन इज वन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड्स बेस्ट नोन वॉइसेज फॉर द पुअर एंड द डाउनट्रोडन एंड एन इंस्पिरेशन फॉर द प्रोपोनेंट्स ऑफ जस्टिस अक्रॉस द ग्लोब। ही हैज कंट्रीब्यूटेड ऑलमोस्ट विदाउट पीयर टू द स्टडी ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स फिलोसफी एंड पॉलिटिक्स ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग सोशल चॉइस थ्योरी। ये नॉवल राइटर लॉरेट रहे हैं अमर्त्य सेन। इनको संसार की बेस्ट आवाज के लिए जाना जाता है। इनका जो कंट्रीब्यूशन रहा है वो इकोनॉमिक्स में, फिलॉसफी में और पॉलिटिक्स में रहा है। इन्होंने डेवलपमेंट किया है इकोनॉमिक्स, इथिक्स, पॉलिटिकल, फिलॉसफी, इंडियन पॉलिटिकल इकोनॉमी में भी डेवलपमेंट किया है। टू लिस्ट बट अ फ्यू, दिस बुक ऑफर अ मच नीडेड इंट्रोडक्शन टू अमर्त्य सेन्स Extraordinary variety of ideas. Lawrence Hamilton provides an excellent, accessible guide to the full range of Sen's writings. Contextualizing his ideas and summarizing the associated debates in elegant prose, Hamilton reconstructs Sen's critics of the major philosophies of his time. Assesses his now famous concern for capabilities as an alternative for thinking about poverty, inequality, gender discrimination, development, democracy, and justice, and unearths some overlooked gems. Okay. First heading है हमारा one of the world's best known voices. What can we draw from Sen's ideas as we struggle to deal with the present crisis and try to remake our world following it? In bringing out Sen's main contribution to economics, politics and philosophy, this book distills his ground-breaking frank work for a new form of political economy, the need for which a crisis like COVID-19 brings sharply into focus. This political economy would be based on freedom enhancing capabilities, analysis and public action focused on specific injustice within revitalized democracy. Sen's work and that of his collaborators, especially Jean Rye, is thus vital for the future of democracy in India. The best way to read Amartya Sen, I suggest, is a series of courageous theoretical and practical innovations regarding how better to solve instances of injustice, be it the support, revitalization and reform of democracy, especially in India. Next, a contribution to economics, politics and philosophy. India, the largest democracy on the globe and the oldest in the developing world, is rightly proud of its post-colonial achievements in terms of formal democracy. Yet this record has not translated into substantive democracy, that is the kind of achievements in quality of life Across the board, the wood empower all of its residents to take advantage of both its growth in GDP terms and the successful maintenance of formal democracy. The COVID-19 situation in India is a powerful illustration of this lack of empowerment. India's associated abrupt and severe lockdown have accentuated the inequalities and deprivations of its massive population. Although the highest infections and death rates are still in the wealthier megacities of Mumbai, New Delhi and Chennai, the virus is now spreading fast in more rural areas in the east and south of the country. It is the urban and rural poor who feel the full force of the three-pronged crisis. The abrupt loss of livelihood due to associated job losses is creating a very dangerous mix of viral spread and impoverishment. The poor migrant workers and economic come from historically disadvantaged classes and caste and work very low-paying jobs without legal contracts. They live hand to mouth. The original decision to abruptly lock down India left them marooned far from home without shelter, work and sustenances, were the incomplete coverage provided by the public distribution system and the National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, यानी इसको नरेगा बोलते हैं. Overnight, this generated a mass migrant exodus which has been compared to the great migration during partitions and as the disease spreads east. For example, it is those who eke out basic subsistences in the poorest status, such as Bihar and Jharkhand, with the high population density and much weaker medical infrastructure, who will be under the most severe threat of food insecurity and affections. All told, the poorest, most precarious and least powerful sections of India's population have been largely abandoned by the Indian state in their time of need. The arrogance and indifference to the plight of these lower caste, uneducated, laboring people brings into sharp relief the extreme inequities Sen has fought for more than half a decade to overcome. Next, her novel laureate. In the second edition of Rise and Sen's magisterial account of the various things that have plagued public policy for development in India, especially in areas such as health, education, social security, environmental protection, economic redistribution, and so on, they argue convincingly that these components, effective public action is not possible without significant change to how it is thought about and implemented in India. It depends on high standards of governance, both in the determinations of where and why extremes, deprivations exist, and how best to keep corruptions at bay and accountability to the fore. It is an indictment on successive Indian governments over the last two decades or so that, despite high level of growth, its latest social indicators are still far from flattering. China may have been less successful at keeping families at bay, but in terms of social progress from ending poverty to the provision of decent education and functional toilets, it has been far more successful than India. Moreover, as regards most relevant social indicators, India is still worse off than any of its much poorer South Asian neighbors such as Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal, and Sri Lanka. With the sole exception of Pakistan, India has the lowest life expectancy, the highest child mortality rate, and the highest fertility rate. In terms of sanitations and the child nutrition, India fares worse than all of its neighboring countries. Its rates of female literacy are amongst the lowest in the region and staggeringly over 40% of India's children are underweight, यानी 40% जो इंडिया के बच्चे हैं वो underweight हैं compared to 25% in सहारन अफ्रीका. यानी कि सहारन अफ्रीका से इसका कंपेयर किया गया है 25%, तो जो 40% है वो underweight हैं. Nobel laureate Amir Tseng is one of the world's best known voices for the poor and the downtrodden, and an inspiration for the proponents of justice across the globe. Yeah. Thank you for watching.